what's in my camera bag, what's in my handbag, what's in my backpack, what's in my suitcase. I've seen videos like these on YouTube, but I haven't really seen a what's in my toolkit video, and today we're doing just that. Hello and welcome to another video on this channel. I'm Rohit. You know me here as Toll Free Traveler, and in today's video I'm going to show you the toolkit that I carry when I go touring on my Royal Enfield motorcycle. Before we get into the video, there are a couple of things that I want to mention. One is that a motorcycle toolkit especially is very subjective, and it depends hugely on the bike that you're riding. I ride a Royal Enfield Thunderbird 500, so the kit that I have is sort of tailored towards that particular motorcycle. In my experience, it should work on most Royal Enfield motorcycles, but there might be slight tweaks required in terms of what you carry. Also, if you ride any other motorcycle, some of the stuff that I use might be useful for you as well, but you might have to add it and customize the toolkit for the relevant motorcycle that you ride. Having said that, cue B-roll, let's do this. First up, let's talk about my easy access kit. This essentially consists of just two pieces. One is a typical multi-tool, a Leatherman Wave. It has a pair of pliers, it has a few knives, it has a small screwdriver, basically small tools that come in handy. You never know when you might need them. The second piece of my easy access kit is also a multi-tool, but this one is quite different. This is something that actually blew my mind when I first saw it with a friend. This is called the Motion Pro multi-tool. These are the things that you get in the kit, but when you piece them together, it's actually a modular system that unlocks a lot of possibilities. So you have spanners of different sizes, 8, 10, 12, all the way up to 14. And then you also have adapters that enable you to attach box spanners of different sizes to this and use this as a handle for the box spanner system. Also, you can attach Allen key bits, you can attach screwdrivers. So basically a lot of versatility from this one tool. It is modular, like I was saying, so you can piece things together to create what you want, to extend the length, to reduce the length, to change the angle, to make it a 90 degree angle. Basically, you need to spend some time with this to figure out how it works and what all you can do with it. But an immense amount of possibility with this. Ever since I got this, I've no longer needed to carry my C-spanners or my box spanners or anything in my easy access kit. Usually, most things that require a little bit of tightening or adjustment, I'm able to do it with just this. This here is my primary toolkit. This is the larger toolkit that I carry, which will reside in my saddle bag or my tail bag. A lesson I've learned over time is that as much as you may love box spanners, it's a good idea to have a set of C spanners, because that just gives you easy access to some of those nuts and bolts that you can't otherwise access with a box spanner kit. You may notice I have a few bits and pieces connected to a box spanner system. These are basically additional handles and extension rods that come in handy when you're trying to do a little bit more work on the motorcycle. A lot of stuff I can do with just my Motion Pro multi-tool, but there are times when you want something a little bit more narrow or a little longer. So I have this T-handle along with an extension rod that I can use for a box spanner kit. I also have this ratchet. The ratchet goes a long way in making life easier when you're trying to remove nuts and bolts, but it's not a good idea to do your primary tightening or loosening using the ratchet. So I have this other T-handle system to loosen the nut, and then to remove it I would use this ratchet system. It's again something that is a personal preference. I feel like it makes my life a lot easier. You don't need to have these things in your kit. This is a spark plug spanner. This is for the left side spark plug on the Thunderbird. For the right side spark plug, you need a slightly taller spark plug spanner. There is one in the factory provided toolkit, so that sits in the motorcycle itself. I just have this one additional one here in this toolkit. I have an additional screwdriver. This is again something that I find convenient. While I can technically use the Motion Pro multi-tool to do all of the removal and tightening of screws, it doesn't need to be easy access, but if I am working on the bike, I find it good to have this with me. And then there is the tester. The tester is hugely useful when you're trying to figure out electrical problems. For tire levers, I use these two tire levers from Motion Pro again. I used to carry normal, ordinary iron tire levers, but they were immensely heavy and not necessarily more convenient. These two from MotionPro, they're a little bit different. One is a lighter tire iron. It's made of a special alloy, incredibly strong, but it weighs less than 200 grams. So it hugely cuts down weight in terms of your toolkit. What I did is I paired it up with another slightly heavier and more sturdy tire iron, so I can wedge the lighter one into the tire and then I can use the heavier one to remove the rest of the tire in case I'm trying to get the tube out. With the lighter tire iron, I did get one with a ring spanner at the end, hoping that that would eliminate the need for me to carry a larger spanner that I need for loosening the nut on the rear wheel or the front wheel, especially on the rear wheel when I need to tighten the chain or adjust the chain. But as it turns out, you can't really get a ring spanner onto the rear nut of the Thunderbird, especially because it's blocked by the silencer. So eventually it's just safer to carry, again, something like a C-spanner for that aspect. But C-spanners size 24 to 30 are incredibly heavy, so I opted to just get this one large adjustable spanner that goes up to size 30, because that reduces the need to carry multiple spanners but still gives me the utility of use across nuts and bolts of different sizes. I have zip ties in the main compartment, and I also have more zip ties hidden away in the side here, because you can never have enough zip ties. You may also notice that I've wrapped up some duct tape over the tire levers. This serves as a handle of sorts, a little bit of a grip on the tire lever, but is also a very compact way to carry duct tape instead of carrying a huge roll. The good thing with duct tape is you can tape it over like this once and then eventually peel it off and use it in case you need to stick something or hold something together. Insulation tape I carry in my multi-tool. Again, it's just folded flat and put inside, so that that's part of my easy access kit. There's also a few tubes of Fevikwik here. Usually there would also be a little bit of M-Seal or something like that that can be useful for sealing leaks on the bike. In these pouches at the top, I have a few accessories that come in handy in different situations. Some washers, nuts and bolts of different sizes, a few metal loops, some extra wire, a few pieces of sandpaper. I also have this little tool that is necessary to remove the valve when you're trying to remove the tube from your tire. So that also sits in these pouches over here. One of the nice things about this Toolpack Pro from Viaterra, which is the pouch in which I carry my primary toolkit, is that it's red, so high visibility, you can see all of your tools very easily and find whatever you're looking for. And it also has this little patch, a magnetic patch on the side, so if you are removing nuts and bolts and things like that, you can just drop them onto this magnetic patch and then they will stay put and remain easy to find. What's missing over here is my portable air compressor. I currently don't have it with me, but I use a RescueTech air compressor. I've made a separate video about that air compressor. I'll link that in the description below. I also carry patches and some adhesive just in case I need to fix a tube by myself. And as I was saying, a can of WD-40. That's not here as well, but that's usually a part of my toolkit. And that's about it. These are the tools that I carry while I'm touring on a Royal Enfield. I've tried many different setups. I've tried to minimize my toolkit extensively, but on occasion I found that with a quirky motorcycle like the Royal Enfield, you tend to need different types of tools to access different parts. So I've learned to err on the side of caution. So there is an intention to reduce the amount of stuff I carry and reduce the weight of the stuff I carry, but eventually I found that these things are at least the minimum that you need if you're going out on the road on a Royal Enfield and you expect that you might have to fix at least a few basic things on your motorcycles.